So we get a ton of questions really weekly on asset protection. And usually these questions come from doctors and other high income earners where, you know, they're worried about their money being protected from creditors, whether it comes from some kind of negligence lawsuit or, you know, they hit somebody with their car. There's all kinds of ways that people can actually go after your money that you've worked hard for and saved up. By the way, this is Matthew Decker, Leveraged Wealth Management. In today's video, we're going to be talking about asset protection in maybe its easiest, most simple form. Because when it comes to asset protection, you know, there's two kind of main avenues that people tend to go. They can use something called a domestic asset protection trust, or they can go offshore. Now, going offshore involves a whole host of issues that we're not going to talk about in this video, but we will say that it can be costly, and you have to really make sure that you're doing things the right way, because it's kind of the wild, wild west if you decide to go offshore. But enough of offshore accounts. Let's talk about domestic asset protection trusts. Those things have kind of come to the forefront of conversation when it comes to asset protection over the last maybe 10 years, 20 years. And they're a great tool if you're looking for asset protection for your money. And we encourage them in some cases. But there are some things that you do need to know about these trusts and how they have to be set up. And in a lot of ways, you know, it can limit the access to your dollars. So I'm just gonna highlight a few of those things. And this is gonna be a relatively short video because I wanna let you in on something that most people don't realize. So stay to the end of the video and we'll get to an easier solution for asset protection than going the route of some of these asset protection trusts. So the biggest thing with most of these domestic asset protection trusts, and sometimes you'll see them abbreviated as DAPT. Number one, it has to be irrevocable or unchangeable, meaning you set up this trust, you put money in this trust, and that decision is made. It is its own taxpayer entity, which means you don't necessarily have the same type of access that you would have to it if it was just sitting in your personal bank account. It's sitting in a different tax entity, which is one of the reasons that you get asset protection from it. So it has to be irrevocable. Don't love that. You have to also appoint a trustee with discretion to administer the trust. And typically that trustee is going to have to be a corporate trustee, or it's got to be an individual that is a resident in the state where that trust was formed. So again, it's limiting how much access you might have to that money. Now, there are some great trustees out there. It's not the biggest issue in the world, but you just have to understand that you're not the trustee of that trust. Somebody else is, which means they get to decide how that trust is administered and handled. And then you also have to have a spendthrift clause in there. And so that clause is basically going to restrict the transferability of that money until the trustee actually, you know, lets it happen. So the beneficiaries of the trust can't just go in and spend whatever they want to spend out of this trust. That's basically what a spendthrift clause is. So these trusts are great. They definitely serve a purpose, and they can be a great way to solve the problem of asset protection. But I want to let you in on something that's even easier than some of these domestic asset protection trusts, where you're going to have more liquidity, you're going to have more control, it's less costly to set up, and all in all, I think it's going to be a better starting point for asset protection if this is something that you're new to. So I'm going to share my screen, and I'm just going to show you what I'm looking at here. So what this is a map of the United States, and it details the asset protection laws of cash value life insurance in every state. So check this out. In the state of Georgia, how much cash value is exempted from creditors? Unlimited. That's what that says there. Cash value of life insurance policy insuring a Georgia resident or citizen may not be attached by creditor of insured. That cash value is untouchable from creditors. Let's look at Nevada. Exemption amount, unlimited. Cash value in life insurance policies are completely exempt from execution, as well as in the form of bankruptcy, which is interesting. Let's look at Florida. Exemption amount of cash value, unlimited. cash value of life insurance policies insuring Florida resident or citizen may not be attached by creditor of the insured. And it also applies to bankruptcies. Let's look at Tennessee. Exemption amount, unlimited. Complete exemption if the beneficiary is the insured spouse, child, or dependent relative of the insured, which is basically every situation where you have a life insurance policy. You're going to make the beneficiary of the policy your spouse, one of your children, or one of your dependents. And is the exemption the same for bankruptcies as well as creditors? Yes. And this goes on and on and on for almost every single state in the United States. Now, if you happen to live in a state where you don't get the same type of protection, you can actually create a revocable trust in something like Nevada. Because Nevada, their asset protection laws for life insurance are essentially bulletproof. You can create a revocable trust in the state of Nevada and get some of the same asset protection coverage while still retaining control over your money. So I just want to make sure that this is something you know about. Asset protection is absolutely important. These domestic asset protection trusts are great, but there are limitations. You lose some flexibility. They're not necessarily upheld in every single state. So if you get one in California and then you hit somebody with your vehicle in Illinois, it doesn't necessarily translate depending on each state's individual laws. Whereas cash value in life insurance is almost always excluded from creditors. And if you're in a state where it's not, you can set up a trust where it is, in a state like Nevada, in a state like Tennessee, in a state like Florida, Georgia, Delaware. There's all kinds of states that are going to allow you to set up those trusts in their states and gain asset protection on your money. Not only that, but it's also going to grow tax-free. It's going to come out tax-free. It's going to have a tax-free death benefit for your beneficiaries. And this is just one of the many reasons that a lot of our high net worth clients, doctors, engineers, business owners flock to cash value life insurance because it provides things like asset protection while also growing their money outside of the IRS's purview. And it can be a phenomenal slice of the pie for high earners looking for alternative strategies rather than just throwing all their money in the market or becoming a landlord and investing in real estate. So hopefully this has been helpful. If nothing else, I want to make sure that you know that cash value of life insurance is almost always protected from creditors. And there's a bunch of websites that detail every state where and the laws in those states, so you can check that out for yourself. But hopefully this has been helpful. The goal of this channel is to make sure that you don't make mistakes with your dollars. Some mistakes are bigger than others, but we're trying to make sure that you make great decisions with your money. And hopefully this video has been helpful in that regard. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Let me know what other questions or videos you might have, video ideas you might have for me. We're always looking for questions and comments to come up with video ideas. Thanks so much. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channel. Click the bell so you can be notified when we upload new content. And I look forward to talking with you next time. Take care.